the demolition day, something may occur. But it is not like that. As the people know that we will be very aware and meticulous on that day, they will choose the next day, December 7th. Why can't we create a new day for India? Instead of celebrating the same day for attack, why can't we make the December 7th also memorable like December 6th? So they can also do like that. But there is a natural caution. So that is known as impact. And the second thing, because of political stand, because of political non-cooperation of India or political cooperation, political behavior of India in favor of somebody else or in disfavor of this country, that political behavior and disfavor, that will also create something. So any social incidents impact, any political behavior is impact. And third thing is international reconnaissance forces, international secret intelligence agencies. I used to say always, there are agencies like this ISI, then KGF, then this RAW and various other things are there, CIA, everybody. I used to always say, intelligence agency is an agency which has no intelligence and which works and which functions as per the idiocy of others. There are two things. I am strong because really I am strong. I am strong because you are weak. So there, strong becomes an absolute phenomenon in the first quotation. In the second quotation, that is a relative and that is a comparative phenomenon. So wherein by intelligence is always comparative phenomenon. If somebody a drunkard, he bluffs or accidentally gets something or somebody is tortured. These are all the several occasions where they can get some information. Real intelligent operations are very limited. Unless voluntarily somebody feeds information inside their mouth, then they will taste and realize. So 75% of the intelligent mechanism, which everybody will accept, retired persons are very honest to accept nowadays. They have written a lot of books, very enfranchised to write a lot of books. They have output their abysmal core of the heart and honesty in which they wanted to serve the nation, but being sandwiched between political and military power, they could not execute. They have lamented their incapability at the time of their service to the nation, which they were very much anticipated, very much they craved for doing that, but they could not because of the exercise of power which is trampling their titanic feet on their heads. That was the reason for that. So technology insufficiency as well as technological dependence. The third thing is technological dependence. If you don't have technological independence, if you are dependent on somebody else, certainly the same technical structure as well as the technical manifestation style must be totally leaked. For example, if you are getting an information or a valid nucleus part of any mechanism from, for example, China or Israel or from UK or US or Russia, any power, then that part is totally volatile for leakage. Isn't it so? Because technological dependence towards some nations for very, very significant things certainly makes us to be volatile, to be vulnerable to the effect of lineage, to effect of the lineage of leakage, by which we will be totally subjected to lot of perils. So if we are having technological dependence, if we are having technological insufficiency, if we are having technological compact between the non-state reactors and state reactors, it is a never-ending danger game. They have started the game. They were just fighting with the stones and rods and sticks. You have taught them to fight with guns, now with unmanned machines. So you have initiated the race, the human race that has initiated this running race also, and now it is paying fruit for it. Now let us come and conclude with the national security issues of India very, very briefly. There is a story which I read in some other place. Somebody told me also, God, he traveled with somebody and he just told that, you see, US, how tall the buildings are there and how great the technology is. Yes, God, you have blessed them. You see their culture. I have cursed because I used to balance everybody. Then he has shown Israel, India, etc. How people, how is their great tradition and valuable heritage. You see, yes, you have blessed them with everything, but where is the balance? You see the patriotism of the people and the neighbors, that is the balance. India is surrounded by such neighbors. If somebody is living with a snake, with an atom bomb, with a firewall, or with a poisonous blaster inside, everything is there inside. There is a poisonous gas drum. There is a snake in the other side. And there is a person with a knife. There is a roaring, hungry lion. Everybody is there and somebody is living inside. Such is the status of India. And Nepal, you know that how Maoistic insurgency was there. And Burma, still we are having, in spite of the civilized nation, still we are having that same thing. We are having Georgia, we are having Congo, but they are not neighbors. See, don't think that they are not neighbors. There are two things. One is just transportation. Second is transmission. If you say just about transmission, it can come from Nepal or Sri Lanka. If you say about transmission, it can come from even Israel, from Congo, because they are having international network. If somebody requires money, how do they survive? We are getting money from the government, we are getting money from the business. How these people, they get money, the terrorists, how they get money? From five sources. One, because of the support of lot of industrialists and plutocratic authorities for their survivance and protection. They must survive. Even they know that lot of people in lot of underground and down areas, down worlds, those people, they are totally nourishing and irrigating the doyens of the underground world, without which they cannot survive. So the industrial society or the plutocratic and aristocratic society that nourishes, that manures these people, number one. Number two, by immoral trade, smuggling and other things, they loot money. Number three, secret agencies of other country to spoil the peace of the other nations, by spoiling which they can, now it is known as a smart war. In the one seminar on war, I told about hundreds of wars. Smart war, cheap war, shrewd war, ugly war, direct war, innumerable wars we discussed on one seminar. Now it is not necessary that somebody to take the military forces and to do war as if it has been done in the First and Second World Wars. It is not like that. There is a cultural invasion. If you spoil the people, then totally they will be the servants of these people. Second is the war by means of their infiltration by trade contracts, technical contracts. It is in the pretext of trade relations as well as a technical transfer, technology transfer, all of these things that will make a dependence. Then these people, they will establish their MNCs, they will establish their operations. Now, before 3 decades, you would have seen Telugu films or even Tamil films, I have seen much. If there is a rowdy, he having a different lifestyle, that is a hairstyle, a banyan, a type of lungi, etc. Now you are seeing the people with very, even more than the hero, the person will be very gentle and decent and sophisticated. You are seeing now. Now if you see somebody as spies, that does not mean that they will be like Superman or Batman like that. You know about the Odisha file incident of the Second World War, wherein by all the Nazi people who were under the control of this Hitler, when they have been trialed by the court of Edinburgh, it is the court of Edinburgh trial, it is very famous, Edinburgh and Nuremberg trial, they were very famous. When these people were about to be tried, immediately they fled to Poland and other nations, they got new identities in new names, and they survived just like normal people, just as doctors, lawyers, auditors, and military people, post office, all the other localities of the society have been pervaded by these people in disguise. Likewise, if there is a spy, if somebody is coming inside, no, I am not joking, it is really there, it is happening. If somebody is coming here as a trade person, somebody is doing here something as a financial dealing or a trade dealing or a technology or something to do with study and work, certainly that person can do a bilateral occupation, one serving as a person as a spy for his country, as well as he can also deal with other things. It is known as bilateral communication or bilateral job, in which the connaissance and reconnaissance of military operations, they are done with the civilians or with the support of civilians or those spying authorities in the disguise of top rank civilians. They will be not just dreaming in the society or roaming in the society, they will be top rank officers. That is what we are seeing now. Now there is no such uniform for spy. Top rank people, there will be spying people or supporting people. Without, I want to say something very, 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 very transparently, without the help of the top rank people, nothing can happen in a nation. Either politically or industrially or socially, the most highest grade of operations are done by people in the highest social standard who are in a safety zone, who cannot be doubted, even if doubted, who cannot be tried by a judicial protest or procedure. Such people are handling these things. We cannot just imagine these things. Without their help, certainly it is very impossible for any person to operate. Such type of thing can be overruled only by instilling patriotism, which must be our tool. Certainly we have to do.